Hey everybody, I'm Rick Beato. On today's Everything Music, we're going to count down the top 10 drop D songs of all time. Now, for those of you that don't play guitar and know what I'm talking about, drop D is a guitar tuning where the low E string is tuned down a whole step to D. Okay, so check it out. So if I play this D chord, and I drop that low E down to D, that is drop D there. So this is now D, A, D, G, D, E. Why would you tune the guitar to drop D? Well, the first song I ever learned that was drop D is... If you want that low D in your riff, because it makes the guitar sound more full, that's Ohio by Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, that's a good reason to do it. But these songs on this list are ones that really take advantage of that low D and use that to play power chords or incorporate it in the riffs in these songs. So really, none of these could be played in standard tuning. I also limited it to songs that are only in drop D, not drop E flat, drop C sharp, whatever the key is. So many times you can tune the guitar down a half step and then drop D, or tune it down a whole step and then drop D. Those give you different tunings. These are only drop D songs. Now, I was a producer really full time from 1999 to 2017. And I was in drop D or drop D flat or drop C, honestly, for years. My guitars were only tuned in that tuning because every heavy band from the early 90s through the 2012, almost all their songs were in drop D. So this is a very common tuning. Okay, let's get to the list. Coming in at number 10 is from this band's debut record released in 1995, entitled Short Bus. That riff is so fun to play too. You just get rolling on those power chords. So heavy, and the vocals in the chorus are amazing. Coming in at number 9 is a song off this alternative or industrial metal band's 1996 release entitled Antichrist Superstar. Funny Marilyn Manson story. So I went to see Marilyn Manson play in 1999 at the Coliseum in Los Angeles, and they were playing probably their sixth song or so. He had just been up on stilts and they had all this confetti come down. He's walking around singing and all of a sudden he trips and he falls over the monitor. Nothing's happening. The guys in the band are looking around each other and he's just laying there and the lights are flashing on and off. I turned to my buddy Mark. I go, I think he knocked himself out. And it just kept going. He's just laying there, right? Just right in the front of the stage. So finally, all the lights came out, and that was the end of the show. He literally knocked him. You know when they say knock yourself out? Well, there you go. Song number 8 was from this band's fifth studio album, released in the summer of 2010. Here it is. Dragon down below, down to the devil's show. Don't be his guest forever. There's a hundred less than ever. Keep the twist of mind. That lick comes to you from my dear friend Sinister Gates, the guitarist from Avenged Sevenfold, who has not only been in this studio, but he's been a guest on this channel 2 times. And as a matter of fact, we need to get him back on again. Song number 7 was released in 1985, and the guitar player from this band is one of my favorite 80s metal guitarists. Check it out. This is such a killer riff that Warren's playing. You have the D sus 4, D sus 2, and then B flat over D, C over E, right? Then you have the little in-between riff. The thing that's really cool about it is that even though he's playing this to this, those inversions, essentially you're getting this. It's kind of like Round and Round, kind of like Van Halen too, right? But it's such a unique riff and really tough to play. Song number six was from this band's 1990 release. In fact, I had the guitar solo from this song in my top 10 underrated guitar solos of all time video. Here it is. Great King's X riffs. I could have picked anything. One of the reasons I did It's Love is because I included the solo, Ty Tabor solo, in my top 10 underrated guitar solos of all time. The solo in the song is killer, and it's one of King's X's biggest songs. The verse part, though, the voicings. So you've got A power chord, A major 7, then it's really like a G power chord over A to D over A. And then before the chorus, it goes F over A, and then the chorus riff is incredibly cool as well. It's a little bit tricky to play because of the timing of it, but it sounds so heavy. Song number five may be the first song that a lot of you guitar players learned in drop D, and it's from a record released in 1997 called The Color and the Shape. Is not cool about the Everlong lick, right? You've got D major 7, B sus 2, G sus 2, B sus 2, then he adds those, he adds the ninth with the seventh there on that first chord, and then has a sharp 4 on the G with a sus 2 on the G. Awesome. But my favorite part is the lead in to the chorus when he does that pedal with the octaves. So good. I love that it's all upbeats. Really has so much energy to it. That is a killer riff. Song number four was from this band's massively big record released in 1991. And you probably know what it is already, but you might not know the song. This particular drop D song is a perfect example of using that low D string to harmonize with the vocal melody. And this is a textbook perfect melody. Check it out. Stop this song without any words. I got so high, strapped in my breath. Love myself, mad at you. You know it's wrong, what should I do? The final step. Yeah. the most fun riff to play. That's an amazing melody. The vocal harmonizes right with the guitar part. Perfect melody, and then the chorus, the voicing. Right, so you've got this D major, then like a G major 7 sus 2, up to B flat major 7 sus 2. But the first time, the bass player, Chris Novoselic, goes down to F with a fifth in the bass on this. Second time he goes to the B flat. So heavy. That is the chord that Kurt Cobain is playing there. Song number 3 is a protest song from this band's debut record, which was released in 1992. Check it out. What's not great about Killing in the Name? First of all, it's one of the best sounding songs. In addition to the bass, drums, guitars, and vocals, the mix that Andy Wallace did is killer on it. But the riff, the verse riff, when he uses that flat third to third, I mean, it's so great. Right? And then the chorus riff is such a strange riff. It's kind of major-y and then kind of goes minor. But you also have the flat 9 thing. And then the weird. There's so many cool licks in that song. Coming in at number 2 is a song from this band's 1996 release. The song has so many great riffs in it, it was actually hard to pick which one I should use, but I picked the main riff. Here it is. That riff gets so heavy when it goes into power chords. When I go into a guitar store to try out a guitar, that's the first thing I usually play. And last but not least, coming in at number 1, what I think is the greatest drop D song of all time. Okay, Spoon Man, right? One of the most fun licks to play, one of the greatest songs and greatest vocals ever. But when I was a guitar teacher, I would teach my students this song, and it was actually pretty easy for them to play, but it sounded so good. You play it with some distortion, and when they would play that muted part at the end, it always sounded so pro. It didn't matter how advanced they were. The chorus riff, too, is so great. So that's my list of the top 10 drop D songs of all time. Put yours in the comments. Let me know what I left off. But remember, there's a lot of songs that you think are in drop D, but they're actually drop E flat or drop C sharp, like Them Bones, Alice in Chains, right? Or they're Slipknot songs, but they're actually in drop B. You know, I was actually going to put Moby Dick by Led Zeppelin in the list because that's a drop D song. But Jimmy Page really doesn't play any chords. That could be played in any key. So that was one of the things that that I thought about. So if you're thinking about putting Moby Dick in the comments, I already thought of it. That's all for now. Don't forget to subscribe. If you're a first-time viewer, ring the bell. That'll let you know when I go live and when a new video comes out. Give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment. That's very important. If you're interested in the Beato book, go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. Follow me on Instagram at rickbeato1. Check out the new Beato Ear Training Program at beatoeartraining.com. And if you want to support the channel even more, think about becoming a member of the Beato Club. Thanks for watching.